They are all finally here. A new hub, a contact sensor, and a brand new temperature sensor. The purpose of this system is to provide a very fast response time for door, windows, motion, and temperature sensors. For example, the door sensor is capable of reporting the change in the door position, open or closed, in around 1/5 of a second, which means this can be used in home automation system to turn on a light almost immediately as I open the door. I will discuss the door, window, and temperature sensors in different videos, but here I will focus on the new version of the hub, the Hub 3. In the previous hub, I went from using two Wemos D1 Mini to a custom design. I added more peripherals and updated the UI and firmware. In the Hub 3, I took this a step further with more enhancements and firmware features. If you remember, the main purpose of the hub is to take messages coming from the sensors using ESP Now and gateway them to an MQTT server. It also offers the sensor status over HTTP and provides a graphical interface to show the statuses of all the connected sensors. The previous version didn't have a place to permanently store data, which meant that all the sensors' information was kept in memory. And when the hub rebooted, it had to wait to rebuild the sensors list as they come in. I could have used the EEPROM on the device to save those statuses, but as you might already know, the ESP8266 doesn't have real EEPROM. Instead, it emulates Flash, and Flash has a very low write count, meaning if I have kept saving the data for every single sensor update, the ESP8266 Flash will probably be destroyed by now. That's why in the new hub, I added an SD card module. This allows me to save the sensors list to a file, and more importantly, I was able to use the SD card to save the sensor's entire history and log every update. So in the Hub 3, each sensor will have a dedicated file on the SD card with all its data. This opens the door to a whole new range of possibilities. For example, on the interface, I can do fancy things like this, showing the activities of a door for an entire day. Here I divided the day into 24 blocks, each block representing an hour, and showed different colors to represent the activity's density. For example, this door was most actively used in the red colored hours and a bit less in the yellow hours, and not at all in the blank hours. Here is another example. For the temperature sensor, I was able to plot the temperatures on a graph throughout the day. These were just two examples of things that are now possible. I am sure having access to this raw data will offer many creative opportunities. If you have an idea, feel free to share it in the comment section. I will use them for inspiration for future versions. Now back to the hub. You might have noticed that the sensors have actual names and not just IDs like before. This is because I used the SD card again to assign names to the sensors and save them in a file. When I only had a handful of sensors, I was able to differentiate between them. But as the list got bigger, that became a bit of a challenge and I needed a solution. Having an SD card definitely made that a possibility. Another change I made to the hub was the receiver. Previously, I used an ESP01 module, but now I'm using the ESP07 module. This should have a positive impact on the range, as it allows the use of external antennas, and as a side bonus, contrast to the ESP01, it has a shield, so it's FCC approved. This change introduced a small challenge though. How will I be able to program both ESP8266 modules in place? They are both connecting using RX and TX, which are also used for programming. I solved this by adding jumpers for RX and TX, so I can disconnect them when needed. Most of the time, I used the built-in over-the-air feature in the firmware to upload new code, but in the rare event that doesn't work, I have a backup. This is also handy when I initially flash both modules. That's why, if you have noticed in the Hub 2, I didn't solder the ESP01 to the board and kept it deattachable on a 2x4 socket. A kinda cool side effect of not having standoff is that it decreases the hub physical height, making it slimmer, and the display is now much closer to the top. One thing I noticed though, I have to power the hub using USB while I'm programming it, otherwise it fails. Could it be the programmer not providing enough current? If you know why, leave me a comment. Before I move on to the enclosure, I want to give a shout out to my viewers who sent me their 3D case designs for my hub. Thank you. Some of you have also referred me to FreeCAD, which I experimented with and was able to create a simple enclosure with snap fit lid. It turned out very nicely at the end. And thanks to your comments and feedback, I made two further small changes. The first was ditching the buzzer altogether. It is far more convenient to receive alerts on the phone using a home automation system. And the second was adding an option in the configuration page to let the display go to sleep and turn off completely when it's idle. And that wraps up the Hub 3. I have assembled a small batch by hand and made it available on my shop if you want to get your hands on one. Getting something from my shop is the best way to support Mr. DIY channel while getting something in return. Because of you, I can keep making more videos and make them available to everyone. Thank you so much for your support.